Hello classmates, hope you all are good. Now children, today we will continue chapter number 4, that is your atomic structure. Now in previous video we have already discussed about the Dalton's atomic theory and modern atomic theory. Now today we will discuss discovery of electron, protons and neutron. But before the discovery of electrons, first we will discuss the discovery of cathode rays. Now, discovery of three subatomic particles, that is electron, protons and neutrons, how they were discovered. All of you know that an atom is built up of three subatomic particles, that is your electron, proton and neutron. Proton and neutrons, they are present in the center of the nucleus, of an atom, that is called what? Nucleus. And electrons, they revolve around the nucleus in different shells, right? Now, before the discovery of electrons, first actually is William Crookes in 1878, he discovered cathode rays, which leads to the discovery of what? Electrons. Now, William Crookes actually, he found that when an electric discharge is passed through a tube, and this tube is called what? Cathode ray tube, right? When the electric discharge is passed through this tube, it which contain a gas at a very low pressure. In general, gases are what? Bad conductor of electricity. They are they are non-conductor of electricity. But when they are under a low pressure, they become what? Good conductor. So what he found that blue rays were emitted from the negative plate. Actually, this is a negative plate, which is this the plate which is connected to the negative end of the battery, and this plate is connected to the positive end of the battery. When you switch, he switch on when the electric discharge takes place. Then what's happened? What he found that the blue rays were emitted from this negative plate, and what he named these blue rays? Cathode rays. In this way, these cathode rays were discovered by William Crookes, right? Now look at the screen. This is a cathode ray tube of William Crookes, and in which he is showing how the these blue rays were emitted from the cathode, which he called what? Cathode rays. Next is your discovery of electrons. Sir J.J. Thomson, he discovered electrons in 1897. And when he was working on cathode rays, what he found that cathode rays consist of negatively charged particles, and he called them these particles as electrons. Now I'm just explaining you how he did his experiment. Actually, Sir J.J. Thomson did an experiment known as cathode ray tube experiment to discover what? Electrons. Now Thomson took a cathode ray tube that looks like a big glass bottle. It was sealed all over, and he also pumped out all the air from the tube to create a vacuum. This tube had two metal pieces, and Thomson connected them to a huge battery. Then the metal piece connected to a positive side, it is called anode, and the metal piece which is connected to the negative side is called a cathode. And then he coated the end of the tube with a fluorescent material. When Thomson switched on the power source, a ray was shot from the cathode. And what's happened? This ray passed through the hole of the anode and struck the fluorescent screen. And then what he found that whenever the fluorescent screen is struck by the ray from the cathode, it glows. And Thomson thought that these cathode rays must be made small particles shot out with very high speed. And he got more curious and wanted to know if they had a charge or not. So he took two more electrodes and placed them on either side of the tube. Just look at this blue color and purple color, and apply electric field. Now what he found that the cathode rays were deflected towards a positively charged plate, and this showed that cathode rays contain negatively charged particles which are attracted to the positive electrode. If they are attracted by the positive electrode,
then the cathode ray particles should have a negative charge. So the particles in the cathode ray are negatively charged and bend in the presence of magnet also. These negatively charged particles reside in atom and are knocked out when electricity is passed through them. And he named those tiny negatively charged particles as electrons. In this way, J.J. Thomson discovered electron, and it was the first subatomic particles to be discovered. So an electron is denoted by the symbol E and with superscript 0 and subscript minus 1. Superscript 0 represents its mass and subscript minus 1 represents its one unit negative electrical charge. Next is your discovery of protons. E. Goldstein discovered protons in 1898. And Goldstein used a modified cathode ray tube with a perforated cathode. Means cathode plate has tiny holes. He observed a new type of rays produced from the anode passing through the holes of the perforated cathode. These rays were called anode rays. Anode rays or positive rays consist of positively charged particles, and now what they are called protons. The positive rays were affected by electric and magnetic field, but in a direction opposite to that of cathode rays. Thus, with the discovery of positive particles, protons was initiated. Okay, now next is your discovery of atomic nucleus. Now, Lord Rutherford, he discovered atomic nucleus in 1911. Actually, when he was studying about the atomic model, it leads to the discovery of atomic nucleus. Rutherford actually, what he did, he projected alpha particles towards a thin gold foil in the path of the rays. And what he saw that most of the alpha particles went straight through the foil, but some of them were deflected slightly, right? Just look at some of them, they deflected slightly and some by large angles. And that's why he, on the basis of his experiment, he concluded that an atom on the whole is relatively empty, right? But consists of a concentrated positive mass in the center, which lead to the deflection of the alpha particles. And thus the discovery of central positive region, that is the atomic nucleus, was initiated or discovered. Right.
Look at this Rutherford alpha particle scattering experiment.
Then next is your discovery of neutrons. James Chadwick in 1932, he studied the atomic nucleus, and which leads to the discovery of neutrons. Means simply you can say that James Chadwick in 1932 discovered neutrons. Neutrons are the particles which has no charge, and they are also present in the center of the atom. Means they are also present in the nucleus of an atom. Then after that, actually what's happened before James Chadwick, Rutherford, he gave its model of atom, but due to some drawbacks it was discarded. Then later on, Bohr in 1942 gave a model of atom, and according to it, there is in the center part of an atom is called nucleus. Around the nucleus, electrons, they revolve around the nucleus in a fixed orbit, but they are called energy levels. And the energy levels, they start with, means this is a what nucleus, and around it, these are called what? One shell, second shell, then third shell. In this way, these shells are there, right? And these are called energy levels 1, 2, 3, or they are also represented by, one is represented by what? K, then L, then M, N, and in this way, so on.
right? Electrons, they rotate around the nucleus in one or more of the energy levels. In this way, he gave his own atomic model. So, according to the modern atomic theory, an atom has three subatomic particles. They are what? Protons, neutrons and electrons. Now, there is a nucleus. The center part of an atom is called nucleus, which contain what? Protons and neutrons, right? Now, the electrons, they revolve around the nucleus in an imaginary paths, and what they are called shells or orbits. Now, just look at here the model of an atom. The center part of an atom is called what? Nucleus, and it contains proton and neutron. Now, around the nucleus, these are what? Shells or orbit. What they are called? Shells or orbit. And in these shells or orbits, what are shells or orbits? These are imaginary paths in which electrons revolve, right? Actually, what is proton? Proton is a subatomic particle with a positive charge plus 1 and unit mass 1, while neutron is a subatomic particle with no charge, that is zero charge, but mass is 1. And electron is a subatomic particle with a negative charge minus 1 and negligible mass 0.
Okay, right? Thank you, children.